Yay, sweaty couch.
Hello, welcome back. It's Dead
Hello.
Island. Which one is it? Escape Dead Island?
Yes.
Okay,
Not
Escape Dead Island.
infiltrate? No, what'd you say? Infestation? No.
Epidemic?
Epidemic.
See, we don't know the name of the games.
Well, I couldn't remember what you said, but
Yes.
I know that it's Escape Dead Island. It makes it hard to put it on my shelf with the other games because this is an E instead of a D.
Yes. Realize I can never mention in any of the. Explicitly say in any of the intros that I'm Rob and I'm playing, I'm on the sticks.
Oh yeah, and I'm Noah. I am just observing and making fun of the
Yes,
game and
making
Rob.
fun of me. Noah's played the game. He's the pro.
The
And
pro.
well, which one of these paths leads me to a secret, I wonder.
I think the right. Because I see something there. Oh, plus one to your million health.
Well, to
Or
my like
whatever.
12 or something.
It never does tell you what your starting health is.
You're not
It could
real.
just be
Oh,
not
so that's
adding
who you are?
anything.
Why doesn't that
I
comfort
guess,
me?
yeah.
Where's the thing? What am I doing?
Grappling hook? There you go. No throw animation. Just a rope and a
Nope,
hook.
don't need it.
My one buff arm on the top
Makes me
there.
feel kind of funny. That was a bad Garth impression. I was actually doing, like, my voice was doing the my bad
I'm giving this another go. Ooh,
Tom
thanks.
Petty
I hope you
impression.
can hear me.
That's what I was
Come,
doing.
hurry. Tom Petty and
I've
his
got
weird
bad
voice.
news.
Your friend Devin, the mutant caught him.
Concerning the
He's
new
here.
applicant,
please, I will have him checked out, but written reference to
Kevin?
the Chinese
Oh wait,
University
are
Police
you
Dr.
thinking
Liu?
of
Tell him what he did to me.
No,
God,
no,
what's
he's
his
alive.
name?
He
The guy
has to
that
be.
did Rolling Stone.
Reasonable clue.
Maybe.
Like a
Dr.
Rolling Stone.
I don't know.
That's the singer guy with a
I don't
weird
know anything
mumbly
with
voice.
classic rock, even though all five
Reasonable
stations on
ability.
my car's radio are different classic rock stations. I still don't know the name of the bands or the name of the songs. I'm mostly just depressed that isn't heavy metal playing on the radio.
There's one station that sort of does sometimes, but it has to be
Yeah,
the right
there's,
time
yeah,
of
for out here Seattle, 99.9 at like 2 a.m. on a Saturday.
day.
And then when
Sad
they
but
have their
true.
own concert, like they do every summer, I'm blanking on the name right now. You know, like this year they're gonna have Lamb of God, and I'm like, what? You'd never have Lamb of God playing
Running
on your
out of
station.
fuel,
Oh, wait, they
Clem.
do
Get
at
down or
2 a.m.
slow
on a Saturday.
down.
Well, you're gonna land for me, or am I gonna have to throw my grappling hook up there, get it caught in the blades, and pull your ass down?
Wait! Dad!
Switch to caveman
Clem!
view.
Come on! There isn't much time. I need to get you out of here. I can't leave without Devin.
You're
Okay, give me
Devin.
what you found here and I'll keep it safe. Then we'll focus on Devin. Whatever I
He
found,
cares about you.
the evidence of what happened here. Didn't you get anything? Footage? Something?
I have this full diaper.
I have this! Data! On how and why it started!
I have
No one's
glasses.
found anything in 6 months, and you did it in one day? I couldn't be more
Six
proud of you,
months.
son. I'll make sure the world sees it.
Is the helicopter
You
facing
have the
the other
means
direction
for
now?
this
Look at the pilot on the
technology.
right.
Yeah.
Now, Cliff, we don't have time for this
It's
bullshit.
just
Get it
whipping
going!
around,
No!
spinning.
This is the prequel, right? I thought this was a prequel to the series. But he's talking about like stuff happened 6 months ago and I don't know.
So the initial outbreak was 6 months ago, because that's actually after the ninja training. It says 6 months later, and it cuts to them on the boat.
Tell Cliff, what
Okay.
was that? Give the data
So,
and
like,
their
I guess the whole
P-70
island
to
area has
Rob.
been quarantined for 6 months.
I'm just curious where this takes place within the events of. You're targeting the wrong person now. Why'd you change targets? Oh, this sucks. Yep. Just
Oh.
tapped me and I died. See, why wasn't I healing that whole time that I was avoiding combat? It takes so long to heal.
Yeah, the start point for when you start healing is at least a minute after your last damage.
A minute?
At
Wow.
least, yeah. I don't know for sure. I'd have to look it up online, but that's what it seems
I'm
like.
always curious, like, if I stop moving, if it would go faster, but I really don't have time to stop moving. I hate that. I dodged him and he still fucking hit me.
Seeking spear hands. He's a douche-seeking zombie. It's a splat. Get him! Clong.
Nope, wrong guy. Oh, still got him though.
Whew, that's good. Yeah, everyone's slow-mo when you do execute. That's good.
Let me ask you a question.
He actually said that?
Yeah.
God damn it.
Fall off. Oh, you should have fallen off.
Did his head fall off the thing?
I hope so. Oh, look at spraying blood down there.
Yeah.
That's cool. Are there these butchers?
Looks like not, thankfully. I can only imagine trying to dodge the butcher and kill all the regular zombies first. Dead is dead. Axed.
I smell desperation.
You smell.
Careful, this guy is Calvin Klein. He's going to name that his new fragrance. Desperation.
Desperation.
Just smells like money. Lure in the honeys.
Honey glow. So glow.
Judging by the tone being used, rather in World War II or Mexico. You see which direction I go?
There's a blitz like that.
Oh,
yeah,
it's stairs. Okay. Just looked like a gap.
Now we're getting to the crazy shit.
Now we're getting into the crazy shit?
Yes.
Oh,
this is the beginning of it.
Feel like it's been happening for a while, but okay.
Crystalline thing. Look off to your right. Lava. Not going anywhere or doing anything. Just sitting there.
Okay.
Doing lava stuff.
That's the way lava go. So, crystal meth. Am I high on crystal meth?
You're made of crystal meth.
Oh, please tell me Linda is like the final boss.
Linda!
I'm here, I admit. I don't
You're here.
So
itchy tasty.
You gotta get rid of those bed bugs.
Okay.
She's a bouncer. Ooh, and shadow ghost zombies.
Where's the plane? Where's the area I can actually fight?
Kasplat.
Of course. Of course, everyone runs faster than me. Because why would they not?
Well, when you're carrying a two-handed weapon,
shut up.
You're much slower.
Shut up. Shut nip.
No, not in this game. Everything's slow in this game. I'm just thinking of, like, when you pull out a rocket launcher in any other game, it's just like, no, you're slower, even though you were carrying it on your back or whatever. Is it a file? Oh, it's pistol ammo. You found a geofarm file in this bizarro place that couldn't possibly exist. Some rando geofarm
guy. Oh, she's, like, dislocating
guy.
Her shoulder to do that.
It looks so much worse from the front. From the back, it's not so bad. Oh, that's right. She's a screecher. It's just screechers. Everyone jumps around like a bouncer.
Target her. Target her, please. Thank you.
Oh, so her dying kills the other guys. That's good. And then she's normal.
Well, yeah.
Ish.
I killed her. I'm starting to get I was just reminded of a really awesome game for Xbox and PS2, The Suffering.
Oh, yeah.
So, I mean, I would really appreciate that kind of ending if it's just like, you know, revealing that he's gone crazy and murdered everyone. I would say that The Suffering did it better, though.
I won't reveal the ending. You might not like it. I thought it was kind of funny,
won't.
But...
I'm a cynical bastard. I probably won't.
Well, you're right, though. The whole game has sort of narrative issues trying to keep things... Although maybe it was intentional. Maybe the whole issue of everything being crazy was the point of the game.
Yeah.
Shit, that was only a dream.
Like, we had a conversation in another episode about Lost, and so maybe people who like Lost would also like that. Like, they would probably be loving this right now because they don't know what's going on, but that always just kind of irritates me. I like to know.
Doorknob opens walls! Yay!
It also would be interesting if it was like, every time it came back here, like something was different. There was some semblance of like progress or whatever, but
it looks.
We were talking about this.
I think it's messier than it was before, but there's no new stuff.
For Linda, I guess. There's a grave here for her now.
And there was a subway off to behind you.
I can't. There's a subway?
Haha!
Okay, so, alright, I take that back. This place is different each time. Cool.
And this stuff over here, I don't know if this was... Probably it was over here. It's telling you to go down to the cave. But, like I mentioned before, now that you have the grappling hook, you can use that one spot.
Yeah, but here's the thing, though, is like... This is... What episode is this now? Seven?
Seven, yeah.
Seven? So episode 5, 6, and now 7 basically begin with this climb down the mountain.
Yeah.
Like,
it's pretty much pointless.
It's just like, what episode am I watching? I don't fucking know. It's the same shit again and again.
Yeah, I think they wanted to have a base of sorts, but it seems like it would have been easier to have it be... Well, I was going to say the beach, but like going up into that little hut and then going behind it and going through all those caves, that probably would have been more annoying than going through all this. So there's some stuff. Is there a way out through this cave spot here? There's a thing.
There is, yeah. Sorry, let me get the camera. Oh, no, there's not. This ends. Okay.
Yeah, subway trains. Just hanging there. Swaying in the breeze. Goody little two-shoes. Goody little two-shoes.
Stupid dog.
Foot's coming for your ball, dog. Anyway.
Back to reality.
Yeah, guest starring Boomer as a distraction. Back to the crouch. Yeah.
Oh, God damn it.
Wow.
So why does it look back that way? That's not where my...
So the camera, I think, hasn't been updated, even though the spot has been updated. Little bit disjointed there, but
I'm still just going the exact same way I did before.
Yeah, two spitters, probably more.
Oh, wrong button. There we go. Wow, that was cool. I actually got the bail after I pressed the wrong button. This is concerning.
Yeah. Freeze.
You can do it. We believe in you.
Come on, Xbox. Is the guide.
I just pressed the guide and I heard it.
Oh.
Wow.
It might be able to salvage. I don't know.
I don't know either. This is intense.
Oh, there it goes.
Maybe. I'm pressing B to return the game. It's not really doing it.
Uh-oh.
Wow.
Physics?
Well, performance. Something's happened.
Yeah, it hit an edge case and probably got stuck in a loop. So it's messing up the... this is unfortunate. Well, guide, Y, restart. Do-do-do, it's sunny, it's beautiful. Darkness.
Oh no, I was not expecting that.
Sneak up on this douchebag, stealth. And that other guy? Oh, nice. someone off over there who can see you. Because he's a jerk.
He's a butcher, I think.
Yep. Definitely. Oh, man.
I tried dodging that. I really did.
And there's several zombies. Oh, it's the runners.
Dodge again. Do you hear me tapping the B button?
Well, you're out of endurance or energy or whatever.
Oh, okay. I always forget about that.
Oh. That was a quick storm.
I managed to kill the other zombies. Really lucked out there.
With your wide swings. That extra blade on the end really helps.
Alright, I didn't die. We don't have to do that a third fucking time. Let's go.
Woo! Run!
I'm still walking in the same direction.
Cliff. No, not again. Cliff, this
is Dr. Fate. Sorry, I'll try to stop whining. It's probably super annoying, and I apologize. Wait, can we repeat that bug? No.
I think you did a dodge at it. Or what did you do? I know you lost.
Well, before I just walked off this, I just.
Oh, that one time.
Yeah, last episode, I think. Where,
I think you got there. Yeah, I think you got there before it even loaded the ladder. So it probably loads the invisible wall when it loads the ladder.
Okay. Or was it this one that I ran off? Nope. Not that one.
So I guess it has occasional level loading glitches, since we've seen it once or twice for you, and I know I saw it once, at least. And the roots you can't walk over. I'm kind of annoyed that when you finished the helipad area, it made you come all the way back here, because I thought you would be able to use the zip line thing, whatever, to go all the way to the villa.
Wait. Oh, sorry. Keep forgetting I can't use my waypoint locator when I'm just coming out of a transition because it just looks back where I came from. I'm trying to figure out where I need to go. Make sure I'm still going the right way. And of course I am. The villa is a place from episode 2 or 3 where I ended up backtracking like 3 or 4 times because we wanted to collect something and we just kept hitting dead ends.
That was the researcher town.
Was it?
Yeah. That one's connected to the airfield through that door area.
Airfield and
haha, hover cars.
I must go. My people need me.
Poochie was killed on the way back to his home. Poochie was an alien? Man, now I want to see more of him.
Do I get to see it poof out of existence? I'm still staring at that car.
Oh no, off screen. Bastaches.
I didn't even see him up there.
Oh, because the beam was right behind the screamer, so...
Well, I was also staring at that fucking car.
Roar! No! Butcher and a screamer. Oh! Two butchers! You might need to take the alternate path if you die.
What alternate path?
Off to the left, where
I'm sorry. I pressed dodge, and he dodged in the direction that I didn't want him to go. That is the worst.
Okay, so this time, don't go through the parking lot. I wish I could see what spot you're at. I could actually tell you where to go. Okay, yeah, so just keep going straight for now. Doo-doo-doo. Birds. Burning car with no road.
Nope.
Okay, after your left, before the fence here, yeah, go that way. There's probably gonna be other things you run into.
Oh, there's a butcher right there. That's where that one came from.
Is that a butcher? I thought was a bouncer. Oh, it is a butcher. Man, they're almost identical. Oh, he can't see you yet. And he was...
Oh, now he's screaming. Okay. I guess the shotgun was a bad idea.
Okay. Ugh.
Is the other one behind me?
Someone. Well, it's runners, but four of them is more than enough to fuck up your day.
Oh, I got stuck on that route.
Yeah. Goddamn. I guess silent pistol that one guy and fall back.
Is this gonna be pistol ammo after I died?
Oh, wait.
I can't pick it up because I'm still in a fucking animation. Let's go!
You know what? I think if you die often enough, it just drops stuff for you.
Sweet.
So let's die a whole bunch and get a whole bunch of bullets. Maybe not. That might not be the coolest video.
No.
Bird. Birdie. Tiger.
Tiger uppercut.
There he is. Pew pew. I heard something. Out of bullets.
It's okay.
Silenced shotgun.
That'd be awesome. Pretty sure I had that in some game, a suppressed shotgun. I'll say I know I did. I know I've had a suppressed shotgun in a game before.
I believe the Army of Two games, one of them had it. He's healing!
What?
Look at his health bar! It's full again! Oh my god! That is bullshit.
I guess if I'm allowed to heal, it's only fair.
Roar. Oh, die already.
I'm definitely killing. I mean, I am. You say that, but I am killing him faster than before. Blessed mother of stealth, don't fail me now.
Okay, so I don't think you can go over there yet.
I'm just checking for zombies.
Yeah.
Other butcher.
There's the other bastard.
I would love a, like, distraction device.
I kind of think... Well, you don't have silenced pistol ammo anymore, but I kind of think they hear where the bullets hit, so you could... Shoot a wall to distract. He's gonna see you.
I know. I just want to get away from the screamer.
Robble, robble. Ugh.
What just happened?
Something exploded behind you.
Something happened and I couldn't move.
A car fell. Rocks fall, you die.
Okay, so I got these two guys attacking me, and their attacks aren't in sync.
Bounce off. Yeah, his health bar was slowly going up.
Oh, come on. Dodge it.
There he goes. Okay. Okay, get to the starting of your combo, whatever. Yes. Now do your spin and swipe.
I still
want
to lean back to the screamer.
Kasplat.
Oh my gosh. Oh, okay, that was tense. Breathe, Rob.
So one car fell. Because, of course, nobody's driving cars through here anyway. Like that other burning car.
And I would definitely say it feels like that they certainly play tested their own stuff to make sure it was. It's like got a new weapon, but still keep it a challenge.
Yeah. Instead of super powered final weapons from the original.
I mean, I don't know, that's one of the things I liked. I really liked Dead Island before they did the patch of
where the zombies always have your level.
Making enemies scale. Because, like, I mean, it's a double-edged sword, right? You have an RPG that's... You go the traditional RPG route where enemies and areas are the certain levels, and so it's like, okay, we'll get beefed up before you come here, and when you go back to previous levels, you'll be super strong. Or you go the other route of scaling with the player, then it's really now leveling up doesn't really mean shit anymore. Because
you get new abilities.
They're always going to be, you know, your level or one or two above you. You're not really going to feel much difference in the game. You're going to gain new abilities, which is, you know, going to add
some mix
of the combat.
Yeah.
Some modified weapons or new weapons that'll add some mix of the combat, but the enemies are just going to be the same.
Yeah. And I think a lot of people complain about that when it was in Oblivion, I think? Or was that...
Oblivion. Yeah, Oblivion had a difficulty slider to where it's like, oh, have the difficulty always be this, and so it would always be that way.
And then the PC version, people made a bunch of mods so that... Woo! I like that there's still smoke coming out of it at normal speed.
Should I walk under it, you think? Oh, what? This does not make any sense at all.
You're now in World War II! Suddenly, you're parachuting and shooting at pterodactyls.
Yes, Dino Stalker. Go watch that Dino Stalker sweaty play.
This is the unofficial Dino Stalker sequel. I don't know. That would be weird.
Dino Stalker actually got me looking, like getting back into the
light gun
games. I've always been a fan of those, but I really hadn't like thought about them much for a long time, for over a decade, and Dino Stalker is part of the Stalker series that started with part of the Survivor series that started with Resident Evil Survivor.
Hmm.
And so I've been I'll be on the market for a European version of that so I can play it with a light gun. But that also means I need there's this disc called PS Exchange, and it'll basically unlocks the region.
On
the original
PS2.
PlayStation.
Oh, the original.
Hence you and I traveling to Goodwill to buy an original PlayStation. And it forces PAL games into NTSC, so fingers crossed it'll, you know, work on my TV and
not look terrible.
It'll work with the NTSC light gun and all that fun stuff, so here's hoping. And I did trade in a few games at the Pink Gorilla in Bellevue, and in return I got the American Resident Evil Survivor, which is the same game minus the gun con support. You can thank Columbine for that. The game was in development when Columbine happened, so they removed the light gun support, but only for the American version. And as a result, there's quite a few people who feel, in their opinion, that Resident Evil Survivor is the worst Resident Evil game out there. I would not put it below Gaiden on Game Boy Color. And I certainly wouldn't put it below Outbreak on the PS2.
Wasn't there a second Outbreak on PS2?
Yeah,
Two versions.
I never tried it because the first one burned me so bad. I wasn't someone who had my PS2 wasn't connected to the internet, so I didn't get to experience Outbreak with other players. I only got to experience it with AI.
Woo! Keep watching that. Oh, except for Screecher up there.
Where?
It doesn't matter. Watch the...
Is that thing screeching?
No, there was a Screecher up on a ledge. Up to your left, near where the car comes down. Not the car, the zipline thing. Well, he's not there anymore, but there's a guy up to your left, next to the stairs. He's just sort of standing there. Blah, blah. Oh, now there's a Screecher. Bastards.
Oh, look at you trying to get me. You're so adorable. You're so cute.
Aren't you the cutest little Screecher? Rawr, rawr.
Ow.
He can just bite you from feet away.
Ooh, he's got him on the
got
back. Look at all them limbs. Beautiful.
Torsos
just
galore.
Beautiful. There's some payoff with this game.
And if you really want to go up to the helipad, you could, but I would not suggest it.
What would be up there?
I don't think there's anything up there worth seeing.
Fuck would I? Okay. Honestly,
okay.
No, I think.
Why wouldn't I want to go up there?
And we can't have the tram go across the whole island. Let's do the upstairs go animus loading.
Well, if you were actually going across the terrain, you could actually see how bad it looks.
I mean,
Oh,
sky,
neat.
it's skybox, I understand.
Ooh,
Wow.
neat. I never actually came over here after going there. You are now on Avatar World. Pandora? Yes, Pandora.
I had a weird dream like this once. Oh, I did, seriously. There was a giant floating island, like, coming for the coast, kind of like a California city. And when it got close, there were essentially griffins. Was that a lion with wings? The big difference with these ones is that their skin was like black lava rock, but you could see holes in their skin to release. You could see like lava beneath this. This was a fucking dream of mine too. It was fucking cool. Maybe wish I was like a more creative person. Like I could like turn it into a book or something.
Totally
But
metal.
now I just yeah. Now I just have this story of like a city being invaded by a floating island and these flying lava griffins. So you told me there was probably no reason to go to the helipad, and then here I am at the fucking helipad.
And so far, it has proven me right,
Yeah.
Rob. Actually, the only reason I ever came back here was because there's one of the hatches to go
Well,
underground.
this is the way I'm supposed to be going.
Is it?
Yes,
Emery
my
Crown's
objective
residence?
marker was on the tram.
Oh, okay.
I'm going to
Sorry. I
Emery's
thought.
Crown, like.
That's weird. I thought you had to actually go into the house and go down in one way and.
But the tram didn't lead to the house, it led to the helipad, which is weird.
Well, I mean, it's telling you Emery Crown's residence. I thought Emery Crown's
Oh.
residence was the big ass house and.
I bet. So I feel like we're backtracking maybe to the lab.
Well, the elevator here. I don't know. Don't ask me. You're already going your own way.
Well, this is where I'm supposed to be going, right?
I don't know. Well, if the marker said to go to the tram or whatever,
And I took it.
then yeah. Okay, so there should be a switch in there somewhere. On the left side, maybe?
It's there, but I can't interact. Okay, so I'm obviously going the wrong way then. Doesn't make any sense to me.
40 meters away, that's weird.
Can't be right, it's in the room. I guess I'll backtrack. This is the first time I've actually like gotten lost with this game. It's always like, even though it's a open world, it's always been pretty straightforward where I needed to go.
Open-ish.
Really feel like that's where I need to be going.
Well, and we saw that one video where the guy was going back through the elevator, and I maybe that was here, but that doesn't seem right.
Think I should be going this way?
Maybe? I have no idea
Yeah,
where
maybe
you
if the
are or where you...
waypoint was like door to door, like a real fucking game.
Yeah.
But I mean, who wants a waypoint? Who wants to just be led by the hand? Explore and figure it out for yourselves. Be a true gamer.
Well, if there was more to explore, then I could see that. And then there's back
Do you
down
think
through all
this is
this.
the wrong way? I really.
I feel like this is the wrong way, but.
Okay, all right, turn around. How about.
Go to the map. Emery Crown Residence.
Yes.
So go
So
up
my
the. So number 9.
to 11.
I think you were at. I think you
I
were
was
at it.
at 9. Oh no, wait, what, sorry, no, I'm at 10 and I need to go to 9.
Yeah.
Okay, sorry, I thought that target was me. So let me just run back to the helipad and see where that puts me. That's cool.
Yeah.
That's really cool. So now I'm at 10.
You're at the helipad, yeah.
And I see a little building and a path going up to 9. So, all right then, let's go in the building.
Well, no, look at the map again. The dashed line, I'm pretty sure that is the tram.
Oh, so should I take the tram back, you think? So
Yeah.
you don't think I should have gotten on the tram to begin with?
Correct. Not up there.
That's okay, so now I'm now understanding what you were trying to tell me. Like, I didn't realize I was taking the tram before. When you said you can take the tram, when I was hitting the, like, or going to the helipad, I didn't realize a tram would take me there. I thought the helipad was, like, a different path up from there.
Oh. Sorry. Yeah, the helipad is basically on the mountain up above the geofarm labs. And the house is on a different mountain.
I still feel like this is wrong. I don't know. We'll see.
Once we get there, check the map, and we'll see.
This loading screen still funny to me.
The animus.
Yeah.
Do-do-do. Practice all your moves. Press the buttons.
No.
No.
So now, waypoint. Oh, 52 meters. Weird. I was... So
I think when you were in there, you just saw the marker and it looked like it was on the handle. I think that's what happened.
Okay. But still, like, the fact that I took the zip line all the way across. I went into that one building and I was still only like 40 meters away somehow.
I think it was just pointing to the next waypoint to get back here. But it wasn't very good at telling you how to get there.
It should have been pointing to the tram then.
Yeah. That is definitely a mistake on their part.
Yeah, you hear that, guys?
You Norwegian developers. Oh, nice.
Brutal. Blah, blah. I like my zombie games brutal.
That's brutal.
I like zombie
somewhere
going at it.
Hardcore zombie on zombie action.
The Japanese love it. Yeah, my attacks are faster and more powerful. I like this upgraded axe.
Look, a door.
A female door.
Alright, I'm inside.
Shout out to Sound of Music. Sneak. I'm the Sneak King.
You are the Sneak King.
Is this a ball launcher? I just saw something.
It is their sporting room.
Oh boy. Careful now.
Or it's the room that they shoot tennis balls at people they don't like.
Right, their faces.
Now sit there.
I'm imagining like someone showing up at the door like a traveling salesman. The Avon lady. And they just open the door. And it just takes her a second. And she's like, no, why? Sorry, I just wanted to talk to you about makeup.
Why is this happening? What is
like,
going
on? The picture of the kid from Billy Madison that he's just spraying with a hose. And the kid's like, why are you doing this?
Why?
I don't know who you are. The guy's
that
like,
whose
kid is that? I was like, I don't know.
Back when Adam Sandler made funny movies.
Oh. I still like Adam Sandler. I never stopped liking him. I will say I stopped like watching his movies. I mean, I saw Grown Ups, but I don't know what else. Oh, Grown Ups and Funny People are the two most recent movies I've seen of his, and I liked them both. But I haven't watched Clicked or Click.
Or that one where he plays his twin sister, which is kind of bad.
I haven't seen that one either, yeah. So I like Adam Sandler, but yeah, I guess I wouldn't say I'm
a huge fan.
Who watches all his movies. But I still think he's a funny guy. I think he's a great guy. especially funny people. Funny People, I felt like, you know, was a sort of a commentary on his life. And especially with
him.
The dislike that he gets from people.
That's probably why he did it. Because that one, I don't think he made himself like some of his other ones. That was just one that he was paid to be in. Yeah. Modern art, everyone! It's a big black canvas with a white splotch.
Kingpin would buy it. Shout out to Daredevil on Netflix.
A big wide white picture, like his comic counterpart. Wears a white suit. He's wide.
Kingpin is Kingpin is my favorite villain, and It's funny that so Daredevil was one of my least favorite superheroes, and so you have I really started watching the Netflix one because of the Kingpin. I wanted to see what they did with regards to him, and I ended up liking Daredevil as a result.
They did a good job with it, I think. He's hard to translate in comics because he's such a hard ass in the comics.
Daredevil or Kingpin?
Well, both of them, really. Okay. But yeah, Daredevil is well known in the world of the comics as being a hard ass who is humorless about everything.
Yeah, I don't read comics, but I love superhero movies and all that stuff. And my father is big into comics, and so in the 90s, like when X-Men would be on Saturday mornings, like it was pretty good deal in my household. I didn't have to get up early to watch cartoons because my dad had the VCR set to record them, and we would watch them Saturday night when we ate dinner in front of the TV. So I could wake up early and go play video games, knowing that I would still catch the morning cartoons. Spider-Man and X-Men were both on at that time. Excellent, excellent cartoons. But yeah, I never really liked Daredevil. I was irritated that he was a blind man and his superpower was that he could see. that irritated me. But I let that go with the show on Netflix.
And they sort of explain it too, because it's not really sight.
It is. It's
separate.
Like it's better. Super hearing. It's better than sight, right? Because
yeah,
he can.
It's radar sense.
Well, better than. I mean, according to the. And again, I don't read the comics, so forgive me when I misspeak or say things wrong. But it seems like it's better than sight because it's like, oh, I know someone who's down the hall because I can smell his cologne. I can smell the gun oil on his gun.
I can
sense the change in the air when he's pulling the gun from his holster. So like, I know where it is. I know he's pulling it out. I know he's reaching for it. Like it's like someone could see, but then still has also heightened senses. And so it's like, it's kind of. I don't know. It's like, it just didn't really impress me, and I thought it was lame. But I mean, who the fuck am I, right? Seriously.
Yeah, Rob. Who the fuck
are
you?
I'm like,
cameras leaning.
And then it was also like bringing it up with the new show. Like I was when the show was announced, I was of course making fun of it because I'm like, oh, Daredevil, he's stupid. Blind man, I can see. Stupid. but I had someone who has been reading comics for several decades kind of lay it out for me like, oh, well, you know, apparently, supposedly, the Daredevil comics of the 80s, like, what I love about Batman, like, Batman of the 90s of the cartoon show are based off of, you know, 90s Batman comics, which I guess are influenced heavily by 80s Daredevil. It's like, oh, you kind of owe a lot to Daredevil because it influenced, like, a reimagining of Batman. And I don't know. You tell me. People who read comics tell
that's
me if that's
true.
Yeah.
Well, that's where Frank Miller came in. Although, like over the years, his shtick of super seriousness has gotten to ridiculous levels.
Okay.
And then he's gotten all over the place, and he's become sort of a parody of himself. I actually read a thing not too long ago about all of the ridiculous stuff that has happened in the Daredevil comics where it seems like each new writer has to come up with a worse and worse thing to happen to people in the comics, so like it just gets ridiculously cartoony how horrible an event is for somebody. The boat, it's listing! Yeah, this is the easiest way to... Yeah, there you go. Shadow zombies!
Am I on a boat?
No, you're in a house, but still, the camera fixes the game camera. Otherwise, you're stuck like this. Sorry to anybody with motion sickness. Shadow Red Butcher. He's a neon red rave butcher.
This is really hard with his camera angle.
Yeah. Oh, why did it focus in on someone outside the room? Oh, get him. Yeah. Something on the... Ooh. Power to the people. You're the people. Roar! Avon calling.
What? Oh, look at that one over there holding his arm out. Is it against the wall?
I think he's dead. Oh, there he goes.
I'm actually like tilting my head. I don't know if you noticed. I just noticed. I'm actually like tilting my head to stay with the game here.
Ugh.
Yeah, this is a little extreme.
Ooh, car! Let's hop in that car and drive the hell out of here.
Destiny. It's a currency up on the ceiling.
Glowy cubes?
Yeah.
Costs one money.
Give or take. Ooh, box monster, he's here.
Yes. He's just dropping his boxes all over the place. But you are correct. Why are normal Dars like that?
Normal Ooh, Dars?
Dars, sorry. What was the text on the King Pool Hustler of the Island? Murica. What? Akon, Membiarchan, Saya. Are we summoning a demon?
You know, with all the references in the game, that could very well be a chant or something from a movie.
Krakoom!
Prepare your butthole.
For boxes! Run! Ah!
I was trying to, and I don't know where to run to.
I think you, yeah, you go out the way he came in. Nah. Ignore
oh,
the shadows.
Sorry, yeah, the shadow looked like it was something blocking my path.
Other shadow. Neon shadows. Ah, camera again.
The PGO uses people. They don't care who it hurts. They intended to use this virus.
Left or right.
Control the world. So we need it work faster.
Going in circles, it feels like.
Before they could take us out.
Oh. He just punched your health. He just punched it right off of you. Run.
Punched me so hard my mother has a bloody nose.
Oh, that floor that looked perfectly fine. Who keeps hiring this contractor?
Yeah, so you mentioned that, and so it made me think about the house, and so it's like, oh yeah, now I'm remembering back to my high school days reading Edgar Allan Poe.
The Telltale Heart.
There's one, I forget the name of the poem, but like, you know, over the course, the you know, his house degrades, gets a big crack down the middle of it, and it's like, oh, it's representative of his state of mind. As the house deteriorates, it's him deteriorating.
I might not have read that one. I've read pretty much the main ones, the Raven, Telltale Heart.
This is a cool office. Oh, for a second there, he was walking on his own for me. Sorry, looking for oh, never mind. I was gonna go behind that, look for collectible.
That would have been.
Now this is like, yeah, this is like a Bond, classic Bond villain's room.
Yeah.
Oh, and even more so with the painting.
Is that water on the ceiling?
It's supposed to be a reflection of water, but yeah, there's no water.
Or is there water under there? Oh, yeah, you're standing on a plate over water, I think. Or is that not moving? No, I guess that's not. I don't know. This place seems kind of upside down. The ceiling looks like it has stuff on it.
Cliff, here's the deal. This is the serum.
What?
It's a suppository.
Good news, everyone.
For everyone's sake, you must use it, Cliff.
Why won't you love me?
I'm your friend. Zombie is your friend. You're a humanity. Sorry, I don't know.
Well, well. What was it you were trying to prove again?
Shut up!
You can't get rid of me.
Damn it,
Yeah, not syncing up. It was like a syringe, and there he's picking up like a beaker. Oh, poison ivy's coming for your ass.
What the fuck?
Instant jungle. Just add water.
Yeah, so like, is he in a hospital bed, and like his fever's just getting out of control?
God, I hope so. You'll see how this ends, and then we can talk about it.
How close are we to the end?
We're actually pretty close. I think you're about to get into the final area,
Whee!
Which we may want to cut this one a little bit short so that we can record the final area as one go.
If you say so. Does this look like the final area to you?
I believe so.
Okay.
Once you go down to the end and look left, I think we'll see, like, floating crystals and junk.
Okay, so I guess we'll cut it here when it says saving the checkpoint. Saving.
In the question marks.
All right, that's going to do it. I thought we were going to finish this in this part 7, but I guess we get to look forward to a part 8. Join us next time.
Yep.